Okay, so where were we? We found out energy in the nth orbit for the atom in for the electron in hydrogen atom is what? Minus of 13.6 by n square electron volt. Suppose it is not hydrogen, it is hydrogen like atom, then what will be the energy? This into z square. Fine. This is for hydrogen atom. For hydrogen like atom, hydrogen like atom again has a single electron only, energy in the nth orbit will be 13.6 by n square into z square electron volt. Fine, where z is the atomic number. Let us solve few questions on it. The difference of 2.3 electron volt, there is a difference between two energy levels in an atom. Okay, you have to find out what frequency will be emitted if electron makes a transition from first level to the other level. Getting it? Apply Bohr's third postulate. What does it say? Differential energy will be equal to a photon emitted, and photon's energy is h into mu. So mu is asked. Delta E, which is equal to 2.3 electron volt, should be this. Getting it? So basically mu is equal to what? 2.3 into 1.6 10 is for minus 19 divided by 6.6 into 10 raised to power 34. You can roughly make it 4, and you can roughly make it 24. This is 0.6. So this is 0.6 into 10 raised to power, this is how much? 15. So 6 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. Fine. So this is direct application of the Bohr's atomic model. Third postulate. Now if you talk about energy levels, I mean this is not a part of theory, I'm just analyzing the energy levels of the electrons, then you'll see that what formula says that energy in the nth level is minus 13.6 by n square ev. Fine. So what is the least possible of number, principal quantum number n? 1. So n is 1, this is the least n. For the least n, energy will be minimum or maximum?
Maximum.
Minimum, there is a negative sign.
Oh, yeah.
Every time you forget negative sign. Huh? It is minimum. For n equal to 1, it is minimum. So n equal to 1 is also called ground state. You can't go below that. Fine. So least possible energy happens when n equal to 1 or when electron in its ground state. Okay. So E1 is what? Minus of 13.6 EV. E2 is what? Minus 13.6 divided by 2 square electron volt. How much is this? Could you calculate how much is
this?
No, no, exact. Why you guys are so lazy? Why can't you just calculate?
3.4.
Minus 3.4 electron volt. Yeah. If you shy away from calculation, you will be completely shattered when you write the JEE exam. Okay, they test you on calculation also, and especially these chapters which are easy, they'll put some difficult calculations. Okay, find out what is third energy level, how much it is. Minus 13.6 divided by 3 square.
Approximately
1.51 electron volt. E4 will get minus of 0.85 electron volt. Like this you will get. Okay? So if you draw energy level diagram, you'll have least possible energy for n equal to 1, which is minus of 13.6 electron volt. Fine. Then you have for n equal to 2. You'll see that there is a big gap between n equal to 1 and n equal to 2 energy. This is minus 3.4. How much is this gap? 10.2 electron volt. Fine. Next energy level is minus 1.5. Okay, so energy level, this is n equal to 3, that is minus 1.51. Next is what? Minus 0.85. One thing you'll notice that the difference in energy is reducing. Okay, slowly and slowly, the next level is coming closer and closer. So n equal to 5 will be further closer. N equal to 6 will be more close. Fine. So like this, there will be like till n tends to infinity. I mean, slowly and slowly they coincide. So after a point, it doesn't matter what is the quantum number. Getting it? And anyways, if you give it large enough energy, energy tends to zero, right? From this, energy is going towards zero, and as soon as energy goes to zero, electron is free, it is not bounded, fine? So that is what, this is, you can say, energy level where energy is zero, and then the atom ionizes or electron leaves the atom, fine? So this is how you can see the energy diagram is. Now, here is the thing. If electron is in n equal to 4 level, how many wavelengths it can emit? It is n equal to 4 level, so it can directly go to 4 to 1, one wavelength. It can jump from one stable orbit to another stable orbit, or it can go to 2, or it can jump to 3, or once this jumps to 3, then 3 will go to 2, and this will go like this, or this. So how many? There is one more. Which one?
From infinity.
An electron is at n equal to 4. You can't increase it. Which one? This. This has gone. This has gone.
All the possibilities.
No.
No, it can go from 2 to 1.
Yeah,
2 to 1. Oh, 2 to 1 is here, right? 1, 2, 3. Oh, 6 are already there. So 6. Fine. So you can see 6 wavelengths can be emitted if electron is at n equal to 4 excited state. Fine. In fact, when electron is at n equal to 4, it means what? You can choose out of 4, you can choose any 2, transition will happen. So basically 4 C2 ways transition will happen, right? So if electron is in nth excited state, so it will be n C2 number of wavelengths will be emitted. So if you just know how many wavelengths are getting emitted, you will be able to find out which excited state it is in, fine? So this will be equal to n into n minus 1 divided by 2. Okay, any doubt till now? Nothing? there is a mention of how you can arrive at Bohr's second postulate, MVR equal to NH by 2 pi, assuming electron is of deep blue wave. We have done this when we studied the dual nature. Okay, it goes like this. This is suppose electron orbit. Okay, this is the electron orbit, and if electron is a wave, it will travel like a wave. Like this, it will travel in a way that here it will join in phase. Okay, so basically the total path should be what? Integer times wavelength. Why? Because you can check from here to here one wavelength, from there till here another wavelength, from here till here one more wavelength, and from here to here one more. Fine. So you can count number of wavelengths. So if it has to merge here exactly in phase, the total path should be integer times wavelength. Otherwise, it will not be in sync with its previous movement. Fine. So total path is what? 2 pi r. This should be equal to n into lambda. Fine. And what is lambda according to de Broglie? H by p, which is linear momentum, so it become mv. So you can get mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. So what de Broglie has done, that coincides with the Bohr model. Fine. Now see, the theory in this chapter is very limited. So we are done with the theory. Let's see a few questions that can be asked from this particular chapter. We'll first touch upon the NCERT questions, because that's how it should start. So now the questions will be on entire chapter, wherever.
What are you doing?
I thought I passed my
phone. Phone is the most precious thing nowadays. You should not lose your phone. Everything is in the phone. All the private conversation and everything. Your bank password. Yeah, of course, few games which you play all day. You play games on phone? No. Okay, anyways, energy in the ground state for a hydrogen atom's electron is minus 13.6 electron volt. What is the kinetic and potential energy in this ground state? Kinetic energy and potential energy. How many are there? Oh, sorry, how much? How much is the kinetic energy? 13.6. How much is the potential energy?
Minus 6.8. Half of this.
So when you add kinetic energy, potential energy, it should come out to be this or not? So is it coming? Potential energy is double of this. Kinetic energy is minus of this. We have done this. Okay. See, you are facing trouble because you are not able to accept that okay, energy is negative. This is negative. If you double it, it decreases, it goes down. Okay, next question. Hydrogen atom, which is initially at the ground state, as if at n equal to 1 it is. Okay, it jumps to n equal to 4. Find out, see why it will jump? Because it absorbs photon, right? You have to find out wavelength and frequency of photon. Wavelength and frequency of the photon.
We didn't do it.
Those who are watching it online, I am Dheeraj from CENTUM Academy. We are located in Bangalore. And if you want to get in touch with us, this is the phone number. Okay? You guys are stuck? Quick. Fast. See this, you can take it like this, 1 by lambda is 1.097 10 is power 7 into 1 by what? Which square? 1 square minus 1 by 4 square, which is 16. Okay, once you simplify this, you will get the value of lambda. How will you get frequency? Multiply this with speed of light, c by lambda. So if you first it is easy to get frequency, you know, just multiply with c. That is the frequency. Okay? So frequency, which is C by lambda, is 3 into 10 to the power 8, 1.097, 10 to the power 7, into 15 by 16. So you'll be able to get the frequency from here. Okay? Any doubt on this? Any doubt? See, it's all about calculation many a times in physics. So, you have to be very, very good with numbers. And having good with number is an art. Don't think that it is donkey's work. It is not something which is respectful. It is probably the most respectful thing among mathematicians, being good with numbers. And some of the highest paying jobs, they only get it. So practice a lot of calculation. Find out velocity at n equal to 1, 2 and 3 level. For that you need to know velocity as a function of n, right? So you have to derive. From where you can derive? You have mvr and what else? Mv square by r, but what? K times e square by r square, right? You want velocity, you want to get rid of with r, so cut one r from here and place it here, and then when you divide, r will go away, fine? So you will get 1 by V is equal to, correct, right?
Yes.
So 1 by V is NH by 2 pi divided by K times E. No, something is wrong here. So let me do it again. Mv square by r is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught e square by r. I am assuming it e square by r square. I am assuming it to be hydrogen atom. Okay. So I will get mv square r is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught e square. Okay. And I also know that mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. So if you want to eliminate r, you can just divide it. So v will come out to be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught e square into 2 pi by nh. So v is equal to e square by 2 epsilon naught h into 1 by n. Okay, so as n increases, velocity will go down. Get the value. Now you will be able to get, right?
Yes,
from here, it's okay. You can put the value of E, epsilon naught H, you will get the value of V for different angles. Right now, next question. Radius of the innermost electron orbit in hydrogen atom is this, 5.3 into 10 raised to power minus 11. This is the radius of the innermost orbit. What is the innermost orbit? N equal to 1. Okay. You need to find radius of N equal to 2 and N equal to 3. N equal to 2 and 3. What is the radius?
Right, right.
R1 is given, so once you get the ratio will be only in terms of n. That's what I'm telling you. First get the expression, R1 is proportional to what? 1 by n square or n? R is proportional to n square, you said. Okay? So R1 by R2 will be n1 square by n2 square. You're getting the same thing?
Yeah.
R is proportional to n square?
Yeah.
Okay. So R, if it is proportional to n square, you can have R1 by R2 equal to what? N1 by n2 whole square. So from here, I can get R2 is equal to n2 by n1 into R1. N2 is what? 2, 1 whole square R1. So it is what? 4 into R1, 4 times. So this is 20.6. No, sorry. 21.2 into 10 is power minus 11 meters. Like that you can get for n equal to 3 also. For what? For n equal to 3 it will be 9 into this.
9 by 4.
Right? 3 by 1 whole square. So 9 into that. Any doubt? These are all your NCERT questions. They are straightforward. And the good thing about these modern physics chapter is this, that there is not a big difference between JEE level and NCERT. So you quickly do the HC Verma exercises from these chapters and make sure you do not miss a single mark in any kind of exam for these kind of chapters. What are these kind of chapters? This entire modern physics, then thermodynamics, class 11th. Okay? Then entire class 12 physics, in fact, other than electrostatics. They are very, very straightforward. You should not lose any mark on that. It is easy to master it. What I'm trying to solve. Fine. Write down next question. 12.5 electron volt this much electron beam is used to bombard hydrogen at room temperature. What series of wavelength will be emitted? You need to tell me series, which series, Limer, Balmer, Pascal, series of wavelength that will be emitted. Getting it? That's not correct. Where this will go after absorbing this much, which level it will go to? How will you find? Did you get where it will go? How can you tell the answer? You have to first find out which level it will go to. After absorbing this much, electron will not be in its ground state. It will jump to the other state. Where it will go? To find that first. There you go. minus 13.6 electron volt is the initial energy E1. E2 will be what? Minus 13.6 divided by n square electron volt. This is energy in nth orbit. Fine. Difference in these two energies should be equal to this. This is what is absorbed, right? That is the third postulate, Bohr's third postulate. Minus 13.6 by n square minus of minus 13.6 should be equal to 12.5. So what is n? Divide by 1. How much that is? 1. And then n is the square root of this. 13.6 divided by 1.1. Roughly how much it is? Don't guess. Try to solve. Huh? Let me tell you, you guys have lot of lack of practice. I can see that. There's a huge, huge gap between where you should be at this stage and where you are. So don't waste any time. Practice lot of questions. How much 13.6 divided by 1 by 1 roughly?
12.
13.6 divided by 1.1, around 12 point what?
12.3.
This is 26, 22, 40, 12.3. Okay? So this is under root 12.3. Now, which integer comes close to this? 3. N equal to 3. It will not be able to reach 4. So it will come back to 3 and stay there. Are you getting it? So after absorbing this much, it will not be able to go to 4. So it will stay at the next possible level. It will not go up. It will be at n equal to 3. Now tell me, once it is at n equal to 3, what all series it can emit?
Lyman
and Gamma. It can go to n equal to 1 or it can go to n equal to 2. Fine. So the lowest level tells you which series it is. Lowest level as in there's a transition between two levels, the lower of these two levels. Okay? So when it makes a transition from 3 to 2, it is Balmer, and when 3 to 1, Lyman, and 2 to 1 is also Lyman. So two Lyman series and one Balmer series. Ionization energy for hydrogen atom is 13.6 electron volt. How much this will be for helium atom? What it is for helium? How much? Into Z square. 54 around. Okay. Let's do this question. There's a nucleus of charge Z times E. So atomic number is Z. Okay? E is a charge of electron. It requires 47.2 electron volt. This much energy is required to excite the electron from second Bohr orbit to third Bohr orbit. From n equal to 2 to n equal to 3 if you have to go, then this much energy is required. The ionization energy of hydrogen atom is given actually, 13.6 electron volt, which you know all anyways. For hydrogen atom, this is the ionization energy. Question number first, what is the value of Z? And its ionization energy is a second. What is Z? You did not get the answer. No, you're going lot longer bit. Energy in the nth orbit for hydrogen-like atom will be what? 13.6 by n square into Z square electron volt. Energy in the second orbit nikal lo, how much that will be? 13.6 by 4 Z square. Energy in third, third orbit will be 13.6 divided by 9 Z square. Fine. So this minus that should be equal to 47.2, isn't it? Both are in electron volt only, so I don't need to convert in joules. So E3 minus E2 should give me 47.2 electron volt. That is minus of 13.6 by 9 z square minus of minus 0.6 by 4 z square is equal to 47.2. Okay. So from here you'll get the value of z precisely. Fine. How will you get ionization energy? Its energy in first is the ionization mod of that is ionization energy. So once you get the value of z, substitute here and put n equal to 1. You'll get that. You'll get minus of that. You need to supply that much energy to make it 0. Fine. So that is the ionization energy. Any doubt? How will you get potential energy of the electron in the first Bohr's orbit for this? Potential energy is double of the total energy. Again and again making the same error. Potential energy is double of this total energy. Fine. Next, how will you get angular momentum of the electron in the first Bohr orbit? How will you get angular momentum? Simply it is nh by 2 pi. Doesn't matter what is the atomic number. MVR should be equal to nh by 2 pi. Okay? So for n equal to, let us say 2, it will be what? 2 times h by 2 pi. So it will be h by pi only. It doesn't matter what is the atomic number. Angular momentum will be always equal to nh by 2 pi. Okay? Fine. So that's it for today, and we have finished one more chapter from modern physics, and you have to do a lot of practice, lots as in every day at least 60 questions, 20 physics, 20 chemistry, 20 math, and you are not asking any sufficient doubts. Let me tell you, you are not yet ready to face the competition. Realize it. Otherwise, you should not realize it after writing the exam. You should realize it well before that you are not ready. Then only you will get prepared. Okay? And I am warning you in a way that the consequences may not be good. You will be then, I don't want you to go to some third grade college or whatever you get, or you pay a lot of money and then get into some. Work very, very, very hard. Okay. Fine, so ask a lot of doubts, be active in a group, and follow it up and back it up with a lot of practice at home. That's it for today. You have the login for the test tomorrow? You won't. You have the login?
Yeah.